It's about 10 to 13 feet deep, which is a perfect depth, I feel like, for, you know, 18 to 20 foot diving bait, because I like for it to really get down and dig the bottom. So I kind of like to overpower the depth of water that I'm fishing, so it'll really grind and kick around and cause a lot more commotion than one that just barely gets down there. Plus you're down there a lot longer, you know, you're in that strike zone a lot longer when you're kind of overpowering the water that you're fishing. And that's one of the main reasons I like this 20 plus, is because it's got a wider search pattern. And when it's digging in the bottom, it really gets erratic and moves around. And I think that causes some fish to bite that wouldn't normally be triggered in any other way. This is kind of like an ideal situation for long cast crankbaits. You know, I've got the wind at my back. I've got a 7-11 rod and a wide spool reel. It holds a lot more line. And with that bigger spool, it just allows you to make a lot longer cast than you can with a regular size spool. What I always try to do with my crankbait is I want to always point my rod right at the bait. And the reason for that is I feel I've got better feel of the bait. And I also, when I know I'm fixing to, I can feel when that bait is fixing to come over an object under the water, whether it be a stump or rocks or whatever. And I can kind of use the rod to walk that bait up over whatever's down there so I don't hang it up. You get hung up a lot more when you don't have your rod pointed at the bait, because you don't have anywhere near the field. Anytime possible, I've always got my rod as straight to that bait as I can keep it.